heart, every woman, its soul in thee. She was every woman. So she could understand their thoughts from A to Z. A, alienated, alone, a sense of abandonment. She had lost her father as a preteen. Her mom busy in ministry. She felt alone, and her siblings were a decade older, and she was by herself. And at school, she was in predominantly white schools, and she experienced a lot of racial bullying. Eva Brown, why don't they call you Eva Blackie? And she experienced racial bullying even in her family, which wasn't uncommon in the African culture, African American culture. Discrimination on the job. God favored Eva, favored her with anointing and gifting and talents. And so wherever she went and whatever she did, she would excel. She would do well. And no matter what she went through, maybe it was, it is well with my soul. And she knew, ooh, child, things are gonna get easier. Because she was a child of God. It's one thing she learned and she never forgot. And because she was a child of God, the love of God was inside of her. And like Jesus, who became all things for Paul to all people, and Jesus felt all of whatever we felt, our infirmities, he felt us. My mama had a way of feeling people. She understood what they went through. She knew what it was like to be poor, and though not she was poor, and though she was poor, she knew what it was like to be loved. Yeah, she was loved by my daddy, and she understood the song, "When a Man Loves a Woman." Yes, she was loved and misunderstood, and she still cared. She'd fall but get up again and again, and she'd live with pain, back pain, heartache pain, you know, financial pains and people turning their back on you pain, and yet she still could focus on caring for others, too busy helping others and being the place that the family and the friends and the strangers and her mother and her sister and her brother, they would come to when they needed advice, wisdom, direction, or even a loan or gift. She had a way of lifting you. So when people came to unload, she would upload the word of God in them, and they would leave lifted, and they would not know she too was going through. And there was no place safe but my daddy to go to and Christ. Yes, caring for others, loving, and not being loved the way she should have been loved, like Christ. You know, putting one foot before the other, to move on, to go forward, to lift up, try harder. A real sense of performance orientation, always wanting to do, be at her best for everyone. To love and help others like Jesus. If I can help somebody as I travel on, then her living was not in vain. From men and women and children who did bend her ear and lay on her heart, she would carry them like a canoe to the other side. She had been hollowed out through the fire, through the limit. A canoe, a piece of wood, a tree that had been hollowed out so people could safely get into that hollowed place. And she would take them over and pray with them, "Our Father, hallowed be thy name, your highest good in every endeavor and every area. Let your kingdom come, let your will be done." Because God is a God of love, and he's going to perfect all that concerns you, and all things work together for good. And she would say to me, "Confess these things, peace be still, and I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength to do it." She was a one-stop shop, a cafeteria of wellness, you know, good plain laughter, admonishment when you needed encouragement, and keep it real deal, hurt your feelings and get it right. until she finally received her well done, thou good and faithful servant. And even then she would leave on a grand day on the birth of our Lord and Savior, where we recognize his birth. She would go into the kingdom. You know, unless a seed falls to the ground and dies, it remains alone. My mother, who spent a lot of her childhood alone, will never be alone because she's always with the Father. And what she's sown into our hearts, my mother, my Shero, is a seed that lives forever because it is sprouting and rooting and reaching and stemming, and that seed will become a nation that generations not yet born will be blessed by the overflow from the tithe of her life. Well done. She has been to everyone what she could, all she could be. And now she finally has a place for herself to rest, to heal, to keep it real and lay it down at the Father's feet. Now made whole by grace. And no one knew the pain she carried. My dad knew. And Jesus. Nobody knows, but Jesus knew that as she was lifting, she needed to be lifted. As she was encouraging, she needed to be encouraged. But she kept giving, and God perfected her in weakness. Even flawed and flailing and sometimes falling, she just excelled in lifting Jesus up to draw all men unto God, to have him high and lifted up whatever your circumstances or situations. She would just give you the word of God so God's word could feel that situation. When God called her home to know the strength of the blood that raises her to live eternally with him, and the pain, the experience of having lost a child, lost her father, lost her sister, her brother, and her mother, lost jobs and dreams, while she was fueling that of others, that pain that hollowed her out to become the canoe that brings others over to the wellness shore was now ferreting her over by grace, where she could finally, safely, eternally rest and love the God who loved her for herself, in her strength and in her weakness. She can lay it all down at his feet. This God's woman, who is every woman to us all. And she could be with Christ forever and hear him say, my Shero, my mama, Eva Jean Purnell, well done. Because you did as unto Christ. Well done. My grace covered what wasn't done. Well done, my servant who tried her best. Well done.